Simone goes E to start off this best of five with the serves. Love all.
Love one.
Well played here to tie it up. Simone goes E from the middle of the table with the heavy spin. Ball stays low, sneaks under the racket. Clever play here as Dong Cho shortens it up. Simone goes E way behind the table. No need to hit it all the way to him, but it's not easy to have such control, such touch. Subtle serves. Simone goes E, I've had the chance to play, and I can tell you, he can surprise you at any given moment. The variation in his game. Long serve right to the middle. Oh, surprise, still table there. Dong Cho looking at it like, table? What you doing? Take a look one more time, Dong Cho. Eh? All supposed to continue. How did that happen? Still in the point from way behind the table. Goes E to the baseline. He can stay there for a while. No! Floats all the way back. These chops, when they come down, are devastating. And he follows them because he knows he's likely to get a touch shot, some push or something similar. Seen him make these shots before. The counter exchange, Simone goes E, has to be so physically fit to play the game that he does. You can see the muscles in the legs, looking like a statue. He always does, built. Backhand to backhand, holding his own, 6-4. Patrick Sheila on the coach's bench for the French showman. Patrick Sheila, quite a showman himself, actually. It was spectacular to watch. One of the best snakers in the game, and you could say the same about Simone goes E. Deep to that backhand side. So here's the thing about the penhold grip. If you're newer to table tennis, it's the grip that you see Dong Cho using, where you hold the racket down like you would hold a pen, or chopsticks for that matter. Dong Cho, German, one of two Europeans right now to be playing quite well. With that grip, the other one from France, Félix Lebrun. Now traditionally this grip didn't need any rubber on the backhand side of the racket. You only used one side of the racket. Up until the early 90s in China, most players, that was the preferred grip. Pen hold, one side of the racket. But right down the middle, it's Simone goes E in his shake hand grip, step back up by one. Taking his chances against a low spinny ball. This one is deep. From behind the table, still finds a way to put it past one of the fastest players in the game. Quality opening spin from Dong Cho, but the response even better. Back to a two-point game here. Again, a little irony in the sponsors of Dong Cho. But a fun thing, too. Ooh, a service gift. Nine serving eight. Pressure inside the baseline, follows the serve well, Simone goes E. Whip-like forehand, keeping it unpredictable. Stays loose where he needs to be. Has the tension to spring him up in the legs. And two game points now. Ripping backhand does it. Simone comes running in to finish and closes the door to game one. German pen holder here, starting it off with the serves. A long way to come back. Simone over the table with the backhand, has to get deep to the backhand side. Seemed that he was expecting it back to the forehand. Quick action here. Dong Cho allowing no rallies this time around so far.
One, two.
Beautiful touch shot here. Simone just guiding the ball barely over and behind the net. Little side swiping action there, center of the table.
Three,
some
one.
Very unusual shots here. Simone having to react to a bit of fortune. Covers the middle there. Wide forehand, side and top. Down near the ground, a little underspin. Almost a bowling shot there.
Three, one.
You come to the Inspire Arena. When the matches are over, you can enjoy the bowling alley as well. Oh, Gozzi saves it, and the effort pays off. Racing in to get that one before it bounces a second time. Tough get, perfect shot, the net of his own. And then a bit of spin from inside the table. 1 point lead here for Dong Cho.
2-4.
So, penhold sensation. Dong Cho handles the Chiquita well with a short stroke forehand. And then short stroke backhand as well, playing for positioning in that point. Coach Ju. Watching on, working with a bunch of the players in Borussia Dusseldorf, the capital for Germany's table tennis.
2-5.
A lot of stories about Dusseldorf. Edge of the table here, Simone Gozzi from behind. Little bit of fortune for the French showman. I remember to get into the top 10 in the world, Simone Gozzi forced himself to play closer to the table.
6-3.
And not all the time. As you can see, he still finds himself behind the table. Very strong in defense, but not afraid to play some offense from way back. Chop block.
7.
In terms of creativity, it's 7-3 now. If you were tuning in yesterday, you might have been part of the conversation about creativity and how valuable it can be.
3-8.
Although, with the newer ball, there's less spin. So defenders, you don't see going quite as far as they used to previously. Games that really require variation in spin.
9-3.
Up for the fast pace of play, Dong Cho handling quite well on that fast long serve.
Ten, three.
But a rocket backhand from the baseline, and Dong Cho has 7 game points. Tight pendulum serve gets a good spin shot, but at about 80%. Simone Gozzi's seemingly safe spin. Destroyed on the other side. And Dong Cho takes it 11-3, a dominant comeback. Simone Gozzi expected to be the third man for the team. But again, a lot to look forward to, and anything could happen. With this event here in the Saudi Smash, ITTF World Cup, a lot going on before the Olympics to affect world rankings.
Yeah.
I think the complaint was the ball kids moving in the middle of the point. Understandable. Don't want to have someone running through your court.
Two, low.
Beautiful backhand here from the RPB.
Three, low.
RPB stands for reverse penhold backhand. The backhand that both Félix Lebrun, Dong Cho and pretty much every pen holder currently in the men's game has to have.
One, three.
The women's game, you've still got Shan Xiaona, Fu Yu. First point on the board here, Simone Gozi. Not an easy ball, but well played here. Dong Cho works with the side spin and plays it behind the body's momentum out of reach. Tomahawk chop. Some serious momentum for Dong Cho. 13 of the last 16 points. Simone looking to change that here. Ooh.
5-1.
Bit of fortune coming back, evening out the playing field here. I thought the flick inside the table was going to cause some trouble, and it did, but the trouble was for Simone Gozi as it came back off the net. Dong Cho really turning things around right now. Remember, their last encounter, Simone Gozi won.
One, seven.
These parallel backhands and the backhands to the wide forehand are so unpredictable right now. Don't know if I spotted Edward Lee in the crowd. But a lot of the players will be watching.
2-7.
Just waiting for everyone to settle around the court. Two serving seven.
7-3.
Very empty shot here. Simone not putting much spin on this ball at all. We've seen him give a variety of flicks inside the table.
Seven, four.
And a nice parallel backhand as Gozi gets another point. He's got a long way to go, but it's far from out of reach. The wrist on that backhand. Yep. My opponent's done it. Not too bad, that face says.
Five,
again, the backhand comes out. Simone Gozi within two suddenly. Remember, 2-7. Felt like possibly even one. But either way, a long string of points here. He's got the serves back. Quick down the line, Dong Cho with a much needed point. Simone Gozi's had some incredible wins throughout his career.
8-6.
Having the same coach and practice partner, well, having Hugo Calderano as a practice partner and sharing a coach with him, Jean-René Meunier. Simone's quite familiar with Hugo's game.
8-6.
We see that a lot with teammates as well. Sometimes the underdog pulls off the upset more when it's a teammate. Oh, the strawberry finds the net. It's been some time since we've seen a strawberry in the men's game. Simone Gozi and Anders Lind, two of the best at it, at least of those playing internationally. Roman Ruiz, we see you. And it comes down, and you can see how disruptive that strawberry can be. Imagine an actual strawberry on the table in the middle of a point. How would you not be distracted by that? That's not what happened, but Simone Gozi's gotten 6 of the last 8 points. And he continues, making it a 1-point game. Timeout on Dong Cho's side.
10-8.
The touch game right out of the timeout. Short touch shot. Testing that. Dong Cho earns himself 2 game points. Back edge of the table. Gozi. A little bit of French fortune. Soft block, but that edge changing the trajectory quickly in favor of Simone Gozi. The backhand out wide to the forehand side. And Simone is still fighting like nobody's business here to capture this third game. deuce in game three. Oh, the arc, the spin on this backhand. I was telling you about how much spin his backhand gets. There are metrics on this. His backhand is one of the spinniest in the game. There have been studies done in Germany to measure the amount of spin on that backhand, and he's got himself a game point. Gozi takes it. 2-1. Dong Cho to serve, fighting to stay in this and send it to a decider.
One.
Simone Gozi fighting for just the opposite. An early exit, 3-1. Remember, every time they've played, WTT's record, they've gone to the decider. From behind the table, the spin, we've seen him back there. He keeps that heavy top and a bit of side spin on. Here's one, then wraps around on this next. To cover the middle the way he did took some serious acrobatics. Simone getting sideways on this one. Short stroke and right back. Just the pivot. Didn't lose footing. No timeouts left for Dong Cho, remember. Finding the middle, taking control of the opportunity. Taking advantage as soon as he had a little bit of time and never really letting go there, staying as close as he can. Just one step behind the table. In the men's game, closer than most.
One.
It'll help off the top of the net on the way over, but Dong Cho close to the table in the fast rally gets his first point. Oh, well now, rocked back, and a lot of topspin on that one. Simone Gozi rarely, you'll see playing shots from his heels. Just having to create some space there for the forehand from in near the body. Out of the first towel break, a 5-1 lead now for the French showman.
Yo,
six,
come on.
One.
Fighting more motivation than usual if he can outperform Alexis LeBron. You never know. The roster hasn't been published yet for Team France.
Nine,
one, seven.
Come on.
It's part of the reason I think Alexis LeBron was so excited to be national champion for the third consecutive year, 2 years in a row over his younger brother with the better world ranking now.
Go ahead, come on.
But not taking his foot off the gas at all. Simone Gozi pinpointing the middle where he can. Up 8-1 now. It's 1-8 on the serve for Dong Cho.
2-8-2.
Coach Ju watching on, reminding his player it's okay. Don't worry about it. Keep going. Changed his mind maybe on what he had called.
8-3.
Think it was more the latter really, as Dong Cho had won the last 2 points now in a row.
Got it!
There it is, the spin of the backhand. Simone Gozi's had his fair share of weapons, but if you look at analytics on this match, following that pendulum serve, one, Simone Gozi's backhand has been priceless. Two, he's got some serious momentum. 13 of the last 16 points for Simone Gozi. A nice tight serve gets a second bounce on the table. Dong Cho keeps it low. Nine. Right off the bounce, the early timing. Dong Cho gets one more point. Simone would probably have a conversation with Patrick Sheila.
9-5.
Oh, hits him in the shirt. 10. And it's a timeout. And even if you just come here to look up and stargaze, the artwork on the ceiling, water park as well.
Go!
Backhand go! From Simone Gauzy earns him 4 match points. The timeout has worked so far, but his job is not done. The bend on that backhand. The strawberry in the net recovery. The rally continues. Simone Gauzy with a big win over a top 10.